And if you really think about it, we're built to have some type of companionship, sharing, connecting, and that doesn't always mean in an intimate way.
Did you push record?
Thanks so much for tuning into our second act with Paige and Silke.
For your second act of life. Hey, Silke.
Hi, Paige. Paige, I had a really interesting interview just a couple of days ago, all the way from Australia, Austin, Andrew Dowling, the founder of Stitch, which is a community, a platform that where you find companionship versus dating, you know. So we've done a lot on, you know, with online dating and finding love after 50, etc. And of course, one of the biggest objections to it is people, you know, the rejection, the people have had such bad experiences. I mean, don't get me wrong, there've been a lot of good as well, but that's coming up more and more and more. And I know it does for you and your clients as well. So what I wanted to talk about today is the whole idea of companionship, finding companionship after 50 versus romance.
Oh, so I'll pick up right from there. Yeah, when you and I are talking about it, so many times clients will be like, I'm just so sick of this. I can't find anyone. And if you think about it, it really is about wanting to share your life with someone. And sometimes that doesn't always mean the intimacy, the sexual component. It's just, hey, I wish I had someone to travel with. I wish I had someone to go to the game with. I wish I had someone to take a class with. God, I wish I had someone who liked watching The Crown and we could talk about it, or, you know, read a particular book. And if you really think about it, we're built to have some type of companionship, sharing, connecting, and that doesn't always mean in an intimate way. Mm-hmm. So when you and I were talking about it, I sometimes tell my clients, why don't you focus on companionship right now versus having to find a person to date? Because that adds so much stress and added pressure that when you're looking for companionship, sometimes you'll find someone to be intimate with, but that can't be the expectation if you're going to look for companionship.
Yeah. Well, and that's interestingly, just what you said is what Andrew said too, is that, you know, people have, they've become isolated. Yeah. Because the only way to find someone is on dating sites or something. And then that gets to be such a bad experience that if you take that expectation away, now all of a sudden there's the barriers of entry have been removed, so to speak, to find like-minded people, whether that's a man, you know, a man, I mean, a partner of the opposite sex, of the same sex, or just friends.
Yeah. And, you know, I take it back to, remember we were toddlers and you were in nursery school or kindergarten. Right away, you're looking to connect to a buddy you can hang out in the playground and swing on the swings with and play hopscotch with and do stuff. It's no different after 50. You want to find somebody who you can connect with and have fun with and enjoy different kinds of adventures, you know, with. So it's just, yeah, we're after 50. Think of it being on a playground after 50 that you're trying to find a friendship to go do different things with.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, and obviously, you know, that can lead to something else, but by not having that expectation, perhaps it's easier for people who do feel isolated, who are hesitant to go on, you know, dating sites to actually get back out there. I guess what's important is that we are clear about our expectations, as you brought up, because if they're not the same as the person or people you're connecting with, that can cause problems too, right?
Absolutely. So big thing is somebody will say, okay, I'm going to do the companionship page and maybe it'll lead to an intimate relationship. And I'm like, no. You're getting it wrong. If you're going to say, I'm going to do a companionship to lead to a relationship, the only thing that's going to be in the forefront of your mind is this, okay, could this be an intimate relationship? Could this be an intimate relationship? You really have to decide if you want to try something different. You know, as we all know, the definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over again and expecting different results. If something's not working, shift it and try it differently. Because, you know, friendships can last a really, really long time. And sometimes and oftentimes, you know, outlast an intimate relationship, whether a breakup happens or a death happens. So it's always important to find someone who you have the same similar interests. That's why I always tell my clients, what do you like to do? Create a list of hobbies that you like to do, some that you've never tried that you want to learn what to do, and start finding out where they are in your area and go to those to find companionships, because you're taking care of yourself. You're doing what you love while possibly finding somebody else to do something with you as well that's not intimate, that's just fun.
Yeah, no, exactly. And I guess, you know, I thought about this a lot because I was started reading about it more. I kind of stumbled on Andrew's information. Mm-hmm. And as I read more about it, there's a lot written about, you know, companionship versus romance. Yeah. What I would want to say is, do you see yourself giving up passion? You know, or not looking for passion. I don't know.
Can redefine what passion is for you.
Yeah.
You know, people can define passion as the sexual passion. That's great. If you want a booty call, go get someone to have a booty call with and then have your companionship over here. So you have to remember that you're redefining and defining what works for you, not what society says works for you, what works for you. Because, you know, you can have, and this is going to sound crazy, but I love the series The Crown. I love The Crown because I love the history around it and all that. So for me, I'm passionate about the history and the dynamics and the psychological component, everything. I'm passionate about that. So there's different kinds of passion. I'm passionate about certain books. I'm passionate about, you know, certain exercises. And, you know, there's lots of different things that you can be passionate about. So passion doesn't always mean the sexual, the like, oh God, I got to have this great sex. We're up against the wall and everything happens that you see in the movies and good for you. But if you want to, that last 5 minutes, but if you want a companionship that you can call up and say, hey, there's a great movie out. You want to go see it. Hey, let's read this book. Hey, let's meet for tea. You want to go for a walk? You want to go for a hike? Hey, I found this great place in Europe. You want to go for a trip? So I know I just kind of talked and talked, but I gave lots of different examples of different things that you can kind of redefine as what's passion for you.
Yeah, no, exactly. And you know, this all started when you and I, we did a segment focused on loneliness.
Yeah.
And which took off right away, which, you know, that's, it, I guess it's not surprising because as
we're
we
all
said,
lonely at some times in our life for different reasons.
Yeah, we all are. And it's become an epidemic. It is a health issue. And, you know, we've done other segments on it. I don't want to drill that down again. But it is important that we are not socially isolated as we age. So, you know, I'm excited about Andrew's platform. And for me, I guess it's interesting because I'm still, you know, on that place in my life. Of course, I am in a happy relationship. But if I were to have to do it over again or something, that's a big thing, thinking about companionship versus romance and the expectations associated with that. And I think we all need to give that some thought to, so we don't create other issues looking for something that maybe, you know, where we want something else.
Right. And it's okay to take a break to say, you know what, I'm going to take a break from dating and I'm going to try this over here. And I have some clients who say, you know what, I'm so done with sex right now that I don't even want anything to do with sex. I want something different. So they're going more for the companionship. And if you're in a relationship like you and I are, you know, I'm still looking for companionship outside of my relationship, of different kind of friends too, because it's really important that you have something with who you're in a relationship with, but you're not always going to have the same interests. So you find companionship outside of that for different things that you do. And that strengthens your relationship as well too, because you're getting your needs met, because not one person is going to meet all of your needs. So when we look at companionship, look at it while you're in a relationship and when you're not in a relationship.
You know, that's a really, really good point. And a lot of the articles I read, you know, brought that up as well.
See, all you needed to do was ask me. You didn't have to read them.
No, the topic is, it fascinates me. It's, and you know, as we always say, we live what we bring you. And we do that both or, you know, through our viewers, because there's a ton of questions and comments on this. Mm-hmm. Paige, we're at the end of the segment. Anything else you want to leave us with on this?
Yeah, you know, I'm really big about define what you want in your life, not what someone else wants for you, not what society says. Define what companionship means to you, whether you're already in a relationship and you're just looking for some friends to do other things with, or if you're not in a relationship, how do you want to define companionship if you don't want to go to the intimacy sexual route right now, if you want to try something different? So yeah, jump right in.
Well, and on that note, Paige, we'll see you next time on Our Second Act with Paige and Silka.
For your second act of life.
Bye-bye. If you have an idea for topics or an interest in a topic that you would like to hear us cover, please visit our website. We have a suggestion box in the upper right-hand corner. Just click on that, drop us a line. We'd love to hear what concerns you. See you next time.